Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Edu-ca-te. Today we're going to be talking about angiosperms as the last division under the kingdom plantae. We're doing biodiversity of plants actually. So we're talking about division angiosperma. So angiosperms are commonly known as flowering plants. So why are they known as flowering plants? It means that at some point in their life cycle they have to produce flowers. So that's why angiosperms are known as flowering plants. So I just took an image to show you what an angiosperm might look like. So you can see that this is sunflower. So this plant is an angiosperm, given that it produces flowers. So now let's look at what characteristics do angiosperms have. Remember the criteria which we use to judge the characteristics of the plant divisions. First, we have to mention if the plant have true roots, stems and leaves, it's the plant body. Remember that the body of the plant, if it has got true roots, stems and leaves, it is not thallus. If it has got false roots, stems and leaves, it is thallus. So angiosperms do have true roots, they do have true stems as well as true leaves. Hence their plant body is referred to as not thallus. So ladies and gentlemen, when you say that the plant body of a plant is not thallus, it means that it does have true roots, stems and leaves. So going to the second characteristic, it says does the plant have conducting tissue such as xylem and phloem. Remember, we're not talking about conducting tissue, we talk of this tissue that is responsible for transporting water and nutrients into the plant. Remember, for a plant to grow, it needs water which is transported by the xylem and nutrients transported by the phloem. Hence angiosperms do have xylem and phloem, which is the conducting tissue which allows for the transportation of water, which is the xylem, and nutrients respectively to the plant. Hence the size of angiosperms can grow big because they've got conducting tissue which feeds them with water and photosynthetic products. So let us go to the third point. How does the plant reproduce? Remember, when talking about reproduction, we mean how does the plant make more of itself? How does the plant bear other plants? So in angiosperms, the reproduction is sexually, where pollen grains move from the anther to the ovule. So remember that angiosperms have got flowers. So there's this part of a flower called the anther. It produces pollen grain, and then that anther moves to the ovule, whereby when it moves to the ovule, then it will create a seed. That seed will be able to grow and make a new plant again. So we're going to be talking about more of this when I do a video on the structure of the flower. So now we go to the last question. Do they need water for reproduction? So in angiosperms, reproduction totally does not depend on water. What does this statement mean? It means that reproduction, they don't need water so that fertilization between gametes can take place. As I had said, that the pollen has to move from the anther to the ovule, and then after that a seed is created. So this happens in the absence of water, meaning that they do not need water for this reproduction to take place. So another characteristic which you can talk about is that angiosperms produces seeds which are found inside fruit. So here I'd say that when the pollen moves from the anther and goes to the ovule, a seed is created. So that seed will be trapped inside fruit. So this is like the fruit, and then this part inside is the seed. So they produce seeds, and those seeds are covered by fruit. So angiosperms, they bear both seeds as well as fruits. And then the last point which you want to talk about is that the sporophyte generation is the dominant generation in angiosperms. What does this mean? Remember, the sporophyte generation, when you're talking about the reproduction through spores, it is the idea that there is a certain type of spore that is produced, and that spore will be able to produce another new plant, right? So in this case, when you say the sporophyte generation is dominant, it means that pollen here, it's the same story, that pollen is produced by the anther and it moves to the ovule. So in this regard, pollen is actually the spores which we're talking about. So when you say the sporophyte generation is dominant, it means that most of the angiosperms produce through this spore, which is the pollen grain moving from the anther to the ovule and whatnot. So now let us talk about the plant body of angiosperms. Remember, plant body, we refer to the roots, the stems, as well as the leaves of a plant. So in an angiosperm, angiosperms have either fibrous or adventitious root systems or taproot systems. So the roots of angiosperms can be referred to as adventitious as well as taproot systems. Well, I'm just going to talk about that in the next slide as to exactly what is adventitious as well as taproot system. So adventitious root system is mainly formed by many thin, moderately branching roots growing from the stem, common in monocotyledons. So in this case, this image shows the difference between the adventitious roots as well as the taproot system. Remember, when you say adventitious, it has got many thin roots, just like this one. You can see that in these roots of this plant, I think it's an onion. So you can see that the roots are very thin. It consists of many thin roots, and those roots are branching out. It's sort of like they're adventuring out into the soil. Right, and then now the taproot system is mainly formed by a main root or primary root system which grows vertically downwards, just like the carrot here. You can see that the main root is the carrot itself and it's growing downwards vertically. It's going downwards vertically and it's got just these small thin roots, unlike this one. The adventitious one, it's got many thin roots and they are branching out into the ground. So now that's the difference between the taproot and the adventitious root system. So angiosperms can have both of these. So the roots are capable of absorbing water. They can absorb water because they've got xylem. Remember that xylem, it is found in the roots, whereby when you water a plant, the water will move through the xylem to the rest of the plant. So the roots of angiosperms do have xylem, hence they are capable of absorbing water, and they're also able to absorb dissolved mineral salts. Remember, the phloem absorbs nutrients, so mineral salts are part of the nutrients that the plant actually receives, but then that conducting tissue, it is found in the roots of the plant. So now let's go to the second point, talking about the stems. So the stems of angiosperms are divided into nodes as well as internodes. So the leaves form at the nodes of the stem. So the stem, let's say for example, this is the stem. It will have nodes. Let's say this is a node. Here is a node. This is the main stem, and then these are the nodes, right? And then it has got internodes. These little parts, these are internodes. So they're telling you that the leaves form at the nodes of the stem. So it means here you ought to find leaves. The leaves form at the nodes of the stem. Here they are. So now this makes an angiosperm. So the stem is actually divided into these parts, this branching out called the nodes, and those nodes are divided into internodes as well. So now the leaves of angiosperms are covered with waxy cuticle. So remember that the function of cuticle, according to grade 10, it is to prevent the loss of excessive water loss through evaporation, right? So it means that when the leaves have got a waxy cuticle, water is not lost from the plant excessively. So remember that when plants lose their water through transpiration, so the leaves waxy cuticle, actually the cuticle prevents the leaves from losing their water through evaporation. So this is the plant body of angiosperms. So remember to always know these points. They can be 6 marks just describing them, and also these characteristics are very important. Do not forget to subscribe to this channel and recommend your friends to stay tuned. Thank you for watching.